Hello. I hope you're doing well today. In my last video, I had received some offline feedback that the text-to-speech program that I used was not the best. It wasn't necessarily easy on the ears. So I figured it may be useful if I showed how I used the text-to-speech. The program that I used was called espeak. To install espeak, you can put in sudo for superuser do. Typically, you'll see the installation show as apt-get install. However, I do prefer to just use apt. Enter your password. Clear will clear that terminal. To use espeak, type in espeak, quotation mark, and then enter the message that you want spoken.
How are you today?
For my program in particular, I wrote a Python script that sent the information to the terminal window. To get to that, I go to my documents folder and the child folder of it under programming. List the files within, and the file in question is this linux.22.11a.py. Whenever highlighting text in the terminal window, you do have to use the mouse to be able to copy to the clipboard. The same is true for text editors inside of the terminal window, which I'll touch on in a little bit. For starters, to get into a text editor, there's actually three popular ones. There's Nano, there's Vim, and there is Emacs. There may be others that I'm not aware of. To start in Nano, type Nano, followed by the text file name or the file name. Control X, Control activates this up arrow, and then the corresponding letter will correspond to each one of the options down below. Control X will take you back. VI is another popular text editor. The more popular one would be Vim, which is V, I, and U, which I do not have installed. VI will show the same information. However, to exit VI is a little bit trickier, as well as exiting Vim is a little bit trickier. You would need to put in colon, Q, exclamation mark. And I do not have Emacs installed, so I will not be showing that one. Within Nano, I'll actually just use the up arrow to get back to that entry that I previously put in. There are several options that you can use. So I'll copy this Python script. I've imported the time library, the operating system library, which may or may not be necessary, and the subprocess library. The subprocess is what allows espeak and the corresponding text for espeak to be sent to a terminal. I'll copy that and I will put that into a new Python file. And I am going to write over the py test voice.py. Y file. As you can see in that file, I already have that in there. Just going to delete all of this. And paste that in. Don't need that much wait time. And I'm actually going to copy this because I'm going to show another way to run a Python file in just a moment. When you exit Nano after you've edited a file, you will have the option to save it there. Yes to save, and enter to confirm the name. To run that Python file, you can put in Python 3, and then enter your file name.
Hello, I hope you're having a great day so far.
To check your Python version, you can type in Python 3, --version. Or you can type in Python 3-V. Oops. If you type in Python 3 on its own and hit enter, you'll be able to enter your Python script directly in the terminal. So I'll go ahead and do that now with Control Shift and V to paste that in there. And to exit that, you can press Control D.
Hello, I hope you're having a great day so far.
So I hope you've found a couple of those items on using text-to-speech useful. We also hope that an actual voice may be more palatable than just hearing text-to-speech. And if you like the video, please feel free to leave a thumbs up. Comments are always welcome for any other items that you'd like to see in the future. The specific items that I would like to cover in the future would be using live Linux images on old laptops to utilize an old laptop or an old computer as a network attached storage, specifically for network storage for a home gaming server to be able to offload your Steam library, for instance. So that is one of the topics I'll be covering in the future, and the configurations necessary to do so. If you'd like to see more videos, feel free to subscribe. If you'd like to be notified when a new video is made, you can press the bell. Thanks for watching. I hope you have a good rest of your day.